everyone. This is Our Lady of Victory Church on North Avenue in Thomas, Ohio, broadcasting via FM radio 93.7, also live streaming via our parish Facebook page. We're about to begin the celebration of the 5 p.m. Vigil Mass for the third Sunday of Advent. A reminder to anyone who may be praying with us from the parking lot, at the evening time, a minister will come out to the covered walkway to distribute communion to anyone praying with us from the parking lot. At that time, please come forward to receive communion. They kindly turn to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. And unable to come forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway, and a minister will bring communion to you while you are in your vehicle. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly. Once again, good evening, everyone, and welcome. Please stand and let's sing together Maranatha, and it's number 61.
Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Indeed, the Lord is
Maranatha, we long for your peace. We come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
As we gather on this third Sunday of Advent, Gaudete Sunday, we rejoice. Salvation is close at hand. For the times we have sinned, for the times we have denied what has happened, we call these to mind, and so prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. God, who see how your people faithfully await the feast of the Lord's Nativity, enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
has come to the help of his servant Israel. For he has remembered his promise of mercy. My soul rejoices in my God. My soul rejoices in my God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. In all circumstances, give thanks, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not despise prophetic utterances. Test everything. Retain what is good. Refrain from every kind of evil. May the God of peace make you perfectly holy, and may you entirely, spirit, soul, and body, be preserved blameless for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will also accomplish it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A man named John was sent from God. He came for a testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. And this is the testimony of John. When the Jews from Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to him to ask him, "Who are you?" he admitted and did not deny it, but admitted, "I am not the Christ." So they asked him, "What are you then? Are you Elijah?" And he said, I am not. Are you the prophet? He answered, no. So they said to him, who are you? So we can give an answer to those who sent us. What do you have to say for yourself? He said, I am the voice of one crying out in the desert. Make straight the way of the Lord, as Isaiah the prophet said. Some Pharisees were also sent. They asked him, why then do you baptize if you are not the Christ or Elijah or the prophet? John answered them, I baptize with water, but there is one among you whom you do not recognize, the one who is coming after me, whose sandal strap I am not worthy to untie. This happened in Bethany across the Jordan, where John was baptizing. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I suspect that at least some of us recall the Baltimore Catechism. Some of us were raised on it, a book of instruction and faith formation to hand on the faith of the Roman Catholic Church. Now, the sixth article of the Catechism, lesson one, titled The End of Man, answers the question, why did God make you? With the answer, God made me to know him, to love him, and to serve him in this world, and to be happy with him forever in heaven. Because this is our intended end by God, it's clear that you, me, every human person that ever was, is, or ever will be, matters deeply, matters greatly to God. We are, as the scriptures have stated, God's prized possession. Now, while we matter greatly, especially in the eyes and mind and heart of God, while we, God's daughters and sons, each of us blessed with real and particular gifts, talents, abilities that God calls us to use for transforming this world, our role in life, surprise, is not primary. Rather, it's a supporting role. One given over to serving God's plan, not yours, not mine, not anyone else's. One that recognizes God's power, not yours, mine, or anyone else's. The one that certainly honors God's glory, not yours, mine, or someone else's. Well, I'm certain that we've all heard someone, perhaps even ourselves, say at one time or another, it's not about me. Perhaps we've either said it out loud or even whispered it to ourselves. Still, it really would be nice if we did it my way. Last week, in the beginning of Mark's Gospel, John the Baptist echoed the words of the prophet Isaiah. I am the voice of one crying out in the desert, make straight the way of the Lord. And this week in John's Gospel, we hear this again, adding clearly that John is the one who has been sent by God, to testify. Not just with his powerful and compelling words, but his very life, his actions and his deeds. John the Baptist got it. He got that it was never about him. And so he spent his earthly life pointing to, directing others to the Lord. More often than not, the world we live in argues against this. In fact, culture and society oftentimes stresses, be great, be king or queen for a day, be in charge. It's true that, using our God-given gifts and talents, we should do something. whether great or small. We should do something to help transform the world. We should always strive to be faith-filled witnesses that lead others to Christ. We should always be reminded that ours is a supporting role, a role that's at the service of God, who works in and through us. And while there may be times when we get stuck on ourselves, becoming convinced that we're the most important, or for that matter, stuck because we believe we have nothing of value to offer, stuck because we think we and how we live out our faith make us holier than others, stuck perhaps because we believe that we're a horrible sinner, much worse than anyone else. Stuck because we've allowed envy or jealousy or the popularity of another to cause us to think that we've been deprived and we just don't matter. My friends, we must never become so stuck that we get in the way of God acting in and through us. John the Baptist's preaching, his witness and testimony, was necessary and timely, not just for his audience centuries ago, but for each of us now, today. Today, when we're continuing to be reminded to make straight the way of the Lord. In other words, get out of the way. Set yourself aside. Let Christ come through you to continue transforming the world, giving a way to others, recognizing that it's always God's plan that matters. It will be forever God's power that's real. It will only be God's glory that's to shine forever. And it's always, always at the service for the good of humanity that we're called to serve. Not only must we make sure that we are pointed in the right direction, but we must use our words, our actions, and our testimony to help others move in the right direction as well. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Through our prayer, may the poor receive glad tidings, the brokenhearted be healed, those held captive given liberty, those imprisoned in any way released, and justice and praise spring up in every land and among every people.
O God of glad tidings, that your church may proclaim to all whose hearts are fearful a word of courage and hope, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God of every nation, that the anger, hatred, violence, and terror that hold captive so many, may it be transformed into songs of gladness that announce liberty in every land and an end to the wars that plague us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of healing, that those whose hearts are broken by life's burdens, along with the victims and the survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may they find healing in the care they receive from others, as well as the sick and the suffering we remember in prayer this day. Kelly Castle, John Charverina, Agnes Clark, Mary Dumke, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Dacia Fertney, Robert Giant, Julianne Jenkins, Dan Lane, Nancy Litton, Tom Markowski, Beth Mariola, Lynn Mattingly, Kate Naglack, Carol Scaley, George Serba Jr., Paula Simmons, Kaylin Tafini, Giovanni Testa, Mary Testa, and Tina Testa. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of justice, that all who seek justice may be kept safe from all harm, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of the lowly, that refugees and exiles may be returned to their homes and enjoy the blessings of peace and justice, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of all truth, that inquirers, catechumens, and candidates, along with our candidates for confirmation and Eucharist, may continue to look forward with joyful anticipation to sharing in the fullness of your Son's life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of joy, that this community of faith may never use our voices to bring harm to others, but rather continue to lift them in praise of you and your marvelous deeds, and that any who may be absent from this community of faith may be led back to the table of your Son and our embrace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of faithfulness, may this community of faith be ready for your Son's promised return in glory, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of the promise, that those who have recently died, Margie, Jerry, aunt of Paul Burris, Father Bob Holler, and Mary Cranchen, Kostelenik, Jane E. Cranchen, Timothy M. Cranchen, and John W. Cranchen, for whom this Mass is being offered, and all of our dead, may they one day rejoice forever in your eternal kingdom. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of hope, that the intentions that are written in our prayer notes book, as well as the needs and the intentions that remain in the silence of our hearts and minds, and those we have been asked to pray for, may be always heard by you, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Joy and gladness, O God, attend to the advent of your reign in Jesus. For wherever the good news is proclaimed to the poor, feeble limbs are made ready, and fearful hearts grow strong. Give us strength for witnessing, that we may go and tell others what we see and hear. Give us patience for waiting, until the precious harvest of your kingdom, when the return of your Son will make your saving work complete. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, who was, who is, and who is to come, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant will sing Come, Emmanuel, and it's number 62.
Oh.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread of the offering, the fruit of the earth, and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of your hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Lord God of hosts.
praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that, serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when, through disobedience, he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death. For you came in mercy to the age of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us. He sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that, gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Edward, our bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
Say to the faint of heart, be strong and do not fear. Behold, our God will come, and he will save us. Communion chant, we'll sing Bread for the World, and it's number 325.
Blood. body and bread.
Jesus Christ, you are the bread of life. Broken to eat and feel the
body and bread.
Who thirst,
We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Always thank you, thank you, thank you, especially this time of year. To all who give of their time and their talent that supports your parish's mission and ministry, and that gets us ready for these days. Thank you also to those who give of their treasure that does the same thing, that supports the parish's mission and ministry. Envelope users, do remember the collection boxes at the entrance of the church. Don't forget your bulletins. There's some important information in there always, but in particular as we approach the festival of Christmas, tape fives are also near the entrances of the church. Just an important reminder of repetition, as a good dear friend of mine who's gone home to God reminded me all the time, repetition is the branding iron of learning. A reminder that the fourth Sunday of Advent, which is next Sunday, now some of you may be there, may not be there, and Christmas Eve are all on the same day. Next Sunday, though, for Advent, the fourth Sunday of Advent, Masses are 8:30 and 10:30 a.m. It's 8:30 and 10:30 a.m. And for those who are saying, well, if we go in the morning, do we still have to go Christmas Eve or Christmas Day? It's two different obligations. So, yes. And as I said last Sunday to the folks at the 11 o'clock, I just want you to approach God and say, God, do I have to go twice for you? And see what he answers. Parish Hope Religion meets tomorrow. Preschool is at 10 o'clock in the Parish Center. K through 6, 10 o'clock at the high school. Edge is 10 o'clock at the Parish Center. That's grades 7 through 8. And Life Team, grades 9 through 10, is at the Parish Center at 5 p.m. And I pray for Joanna Pasco, who has COVID, and we hope that she'll be done by next weekend because we need her. Advent Communal Reconciliation is tomorrow, Sunday at 2 p.m. at Holy Family in Stowe. There will be many additional confessors. Don't forget this Wednesday, it's really been a beautiful experience. At 7 p.m., there's Eucharistic Exposition and Advent Evening Prayer in church, so we hope to see you there. The Keep Christ in Christmas poster contest that was sponsored by Ernest of Columbus. Do check out the bulletin boards for the entries, and I believe it's that bulletin board. Well, it's to my right. When you go out that door in the parking lot, there's a bulletin board there that has the winners on it, so you can check those out. The Parish Center offices will be closed Friday, December 22nd, through and including Tuesday, December 26th, for the Christmas holidays. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent, and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that, rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain.